A concert's not a concert unless you got a march in it. That's always a great way to start with some energy this year. And speaking of starting with some energy this year, I want to start by saying welcome. Welcome to the first of many music performance opportunities here in the wonderful Oconomowoc Arts Center. While it's one of our first performances as the three bands take the stage this year, we've already had a wonderfully busy season of performing and supporting our community at football games, at local openings of new establishments, as well as downtown at the band shell. And a lot of our students and parents have had a great role in making sure all those things happen. So I want to say welcome, if you've never been here before, to one of our band concerts, and also you want to say welcome back to everybody else that's been to our band concerts before. It's nice to have you. My name is Mr. Henkel, and I get to direct the concert band, these wonderful musicians on stage. And our first number was just that, one of those military marches that's toe-tapping and gets the energy going right from the edge of the show. Our next piece that we're going to perform for you this evening is a piece of music that's a little bit different in a few different ways. First, it's an overture. Overture, what that literally means is it's a symmetrical form of ABA. So you're going to hear something at the beginning, but you're going to hear the same style of music at the end with something contrasting in the middle. But what makes this next piece significant is that it's a piece of music that doesn't end and begin and revolve around the scale 3-1. Those of you that know music or have ever seen The Sound of Music movies, what are the first three syllables? Do, re, mi, right? And all the tone, all the songs that we hear on the radio today, or maybe online today, because who listens to the radio anymore? But they always revolve around do, or scale degree one. The next piece we're going to play for you is special because it does not revolve and end and begin on scale degree one or do. Instead, it ends on scale degree two, which is the re. And this is called Dorian mode. It's something that goes all the way back to before Baroque music, all the way back to before the Renaissance, when music was starting to be recorded by the establishment of the religious institutions. And to connect that far back for some of our musicians is hard. So this is the way we introduced it. How many of you remember the video game that came out, that you had a campaign where you had to go to outer space and beat up guys, and it had an H in it? Halo, yes, Halo. Who here knows about Halo? We've heard about the game a few times. That theme song, with that guy that starts singing the theme song, oh, oh, am I close? That was one that it exactly is one that revolves around scale 3-2 or do. So that's kind of how we introduced and connected it with the piece. They kind of appreciate it. This is going to sound a little different, but it's still going to be totally fun to study. So, ladies and gentlemen, the concert band now presents for you John Kenyon's, written in 1986, City of Glass and Overture. Thank you. One of the wonderful things about Okana Walk is that we have so many wonderful elements of support that help promote opportunities for our musicians. And one of those entities is our Okana Walk Band-Aids. And our Band-Aids has worked tirelessly in a lot of different ways to support a lot of our efforts, from providing different supplements for summer scholarship opportunities for our students, but also supporting the day-to-day needs for those of the jazz dance and so on. And I'd like to share with you for one of their announcements tonight. They've got two fundraisers I'd like to share with you. One is gonna be the 50-50 raffle. The Band-Aids is selling a Year of Band 50-50 raffle tickets out in the lobby by concessions. These will be sold only at our band concerts this year and at the May 3rd Bandorama, where we will pick the winning ticket. 50% of ticket sales will go to the owner of the winning ticket, and 50% will go into the band trip fund that Band-Aids is establishing for future trips. And if you know anything about the history of the band program here, there's lots of opportunities, from trips for jazz bands, from trips to Dixie Classic in Chicago, trips to Disney, and lots of opportunities, not just to share our musical talents of all these wonderful students here in our own hometown of Okanawha, but all across the Midwest and the great nation of the United States. So if you're interested in that, please feel free to grab a raffle ticket out at the concessions. The final piece the concert band will present to us this evening is another piece of music that is sort of a programmatic piece of music, in which it kind of paints a picture of a journey through music. This next piece, called Jubilance, is going to be a piece that starts with some light, fun energy, mixes different time signatures in, from the duple time signatures of 4-4 to the compound time signatures of 6-8. It has a different type of feel to it. In the middle of the piece, you're going to hear some more lyrical playing that contrasts nicely to that energy that will come back in the end. We appreciate your support tonight. And after we play this piece, we will quickly transition to our next ensemble. And we ask during that time, if you need to quickly use the restroom, please do so, stretch, but we'll be making the transition very quick to make sure the night doesn't get too long for everyone. Thank you very much, and this is Concert Band's Jubilance.
Thank you. Thank you. Okay, we're running. Good evening, everyone, and welcome to our fall concert. It is great to see such a wonderful crowd tonight. And before I talk about what we just did, I'd like to congratulate the concert band and Mr. Henkel for their fine work. They sounded outstanding. And so let's give them a big round of applause. So that first piece that you heard is really three pieces in one. Prelude, Siciliano, and the Rondo. What do you think was the hardest one? The Prelude, the Siciliano, or the Rondo? What would you guess? You'd think, you might say the fast one, right? It's the slow stuff. So working on slow music, which is stretched out and lyrical, that's something that we continue to work on. I'm really proud of what this band is doing, and you're going to hear a lot more of that playing in this next piece. It's going to feature a lot of beautiful lyricism as well. So that first piece was originally written just for a brass ensemble. And the great John Painter, who arranged that, he was the professor at Northwestern University for about 38 years, I believe. And he put that and set it into that setting, so it was a lot of fun. Our next piece of music is about a piece of music, a place that is the highest point on planet Earth. It's Mount Everest. And you're going to hear some soaring lines. And if you listen to a great movie soundtrack, usually it's the French horn section that I think portrays that type of, I don't know, that floaty kind of sound. So I'm not trying to put any pressure on the horns, but I want you to pay attention to this great French horn section, and you're going to hear another great one in a minute. So without further ado, this is Mount Everest. I'm not sure, I think Mr. Henkel read off the first, did he talk about the 50-50 raffle already? Did he talk about that? Okay. And I'm going to read the next one, because our wonderful Band-Aids organization, which is full of many parents, always looking for more parent volunteers. The next thing on our list is the City Tin Fundraiser. All band students will be selling 2023 City Tins again this year for the band program. The sale started yesterday and will run through November 11th. Students will get their order forms tomorrow in class. We do have some here for sale at the concessions table on the way out. If you need one right away, they are $30, and lots of great places that you can utilize those City Tins. So thank you to the Band-Aids for putting in all that time and effort and putting these great fundraisers together. We'll talk more about some other things. So without further ado, Mount Everest.
Thank you.
1 minute and 30 seconds. So that piece, Gevorkne, let me tell you the deep meaning of the title. It means nothing. Jack Stamp, who wrote that piece, great professors at Cincinnati Conservatory, then Indiana University, a great concert program, one of the best in the world, debuted that piece in 1991. And Jack Stamp just said, I wanted a nonsense word to title the tune. But what you did hear in that piece was tons of clashing. How many of you raise your hand if you noticed notes that sounded like they were crunchy? Or maybe they didn't sound as harmonic as you might hear like on a Sunday morning with a Bach chorale. Which, by the way, at the end of this piece, you're going to hear some beautiful Bach chorales. But this piece was intended to be a great fast opener, and away we go. So there you have it. I would like to, before we could play, again, I acknowledge Mr. Henkel, you were probably moving stuff around. First of all, thank you for all that great help. But Mr. Henkel's going to be joining us on the piano for this piece. Let's give him a big round of applause. And also, before there's lots of people on his name, but give the brass players a chance to get the blood back. Mr. Henkel is circulating around. He's been here for the last week or two. working on all our percussion, fixing, tweaking, tuning, working with percussion. So, Mr. Herkey, wherever you are, thank you so much for all the help that you've done. Thank you. Appreciate it. All right. This next piece, is the last name is a mystery. You might say it's Maslankas, but it's Maslanka. The S is silent. And one of the hottest names in composing, along with Frank Tekeli, you're going to hear from. This is a two-movement piece. It starts off kind of serene and subtle, then we just keep building and then bring it back down. We hope you enjoy it.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Even with a torn labrum and a rotator cuff, that's still a lot of fun.
Holy cow. Wow.
Okay.
I feel like we were on a treadmill for quite a while. It was a lot of fun. Wynn Symphony, thank you for that. That was a gift, not only to the audience, but to myself and to each other. That was beautiful. All right, we're going to slow things down. How many of you have heard the tune? I'm sure you have. Oh, Danny Boy. Have you ever heard that song? Any Irish people in this? Okay, at least three? Okay, sure. Well, this is one of my favorite composers, Percy Grainger. Percy Grainger loved color, and you're going to hear, again, a lot of some of these crunchy notes that are not 1-3-5-3-1, however, you're going to hear ones against twos and fours against threes and things like that. But Grainger had this way of just using those notes in a tasteful way, much like the great Miles Davis did in the jazz video. But this is such a beautiful setting, and we hope you enjoy it. I always like to have one piece that will give the audience an opportunity to reflect on whatever it is you'd like to reflect upon. You just heard a lot of volume, a lot of notes. This is the opposite. Enjoy it and think about what you must think about. All right. Pretty stuff, isn't it? Elton took a chance to enjoy that. And hey, I know, I myself don't typically sit at home and listen to an hour and a half straight of concert band music. I know, you're hanging in there. You're hanging in there. Concert band, it's a punk band, thank you. This one's going to wake you up. This is our last one. This is about an exploding volcano. So that's what people like, some excitement. So this is about Pompeii, Vesuvius, the great Frank Ticelli. So we're going to wake you up, and we'll send you out feeling really good about things. I want to thank every band student in this program for being a band. They bring us great joy, Mr. Nickel and I, and all the great band directors and choir directors, orchestra in our district. I know at least one is here tonight. There might be more. But I know I saw the great Mrs. Susan Ohm. Mrs. Susan Ohm. Can you please stand up, Susan, and receive some applause? She's still singing. So I am forever indebted for the great work. And I've wanted for so many years to be part of a program where my students came to me and said, we had such a great time in eighth grade. Prove it to me that it's going to be fun. That's what I've always wanted. So thank you for doing that. I want to thank the great parents of Band-Aids. Right now, we need you more than ever because we're trying to do something very special for this district. This music program has been on the map for 60 plus years. I know the great Dave Royal is probably here too. Dave, are you in the audience tonight? I know you've been part of some of the greatest bands, and this band room is big enough for half a band. And right now, they're going to be talking about redoing the whole band, choir, orchestra, the art, the HVAC, and some other great athletic facilities. But that's going to be coming up. And it will give the students room for practicing, for storage, adequate acoustics, so it's safer on their ears. So be looking out for that. So the Band-Aids are part of that right now, along with their new superintendent, so thank you. But for all the fundraisers, for the uniform fittings, for the chili feeds coming, for everything you do, band camp, thank you, the car washes, thank you. Now, let's give it up for all the great Band-Aids. You're the president, so I'm going to give you up for your hands. You should go to the kids, 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 thank you. All right, so check out the goodies and lobby, food for sale, all that good stuff. We'll see you in some upcoming events. But without further ado, Vesuvius, thank you. Percussionists, you are cordially required to come, and we will move all the stuff afterwards. I could use a team of students. We'll help the OEC as a concert tomorrow night. We've got to get set for the orchestra. Thank you so much. Here's Vesuvius. Thank you.
Thank you. celebrating this great music with us. We really appreciate it, the great support. Oh man, we have another few concerts on November 1st, both 8th grade, Silver Lake, Nature Hill, Wind Symphony will be performing at Nature Hill. Come to that concert at 6:30. Alright, 6:30 we'll be there, and the Dancing Fed, so we'll be there. Thank you for everything. We'll see you all very soon, and see you in the holiday concert and the holiday parade. Thank you all for being here tonight.